to get the opportunity to pursue a career that I love, which is sport, was just, it was boys town stuff.
As the years have gone on, that's the thing I remember about NBN more than anything else, is that I was taken into a family.
TV was huge. It was our dream. It was cinema at home.
There's been some really valuable life lessons, I guess, and they're not just work colleagues, they're people who really are part of your life.
50 years. I've been part of that 50 years. Happy birthday.
Television was a very new thing. Sydney and Melbourne had it, and I think Brisbane and Perth had just got it, but nowhere outside the cities had ever seen television. All of us people who were totally new to television, living, sharing, working with people who had quite a lot of expertise, and a wonderful creative period emerged. 'Cause three's a crowd. The people who set up NBN did two, in my view, very proper things. A lot of the staff they employed were locals, which was good for local young people's employment. But in every department, they tried to bring in someone with experience. So we got a floor manager from England, we got a cameraman who was a Dutchman working in Sydney, we got a kids show director who was American, we got a news editor who was a New Zealander but working in Canada. And we, yeah, they came from all over. It was just a tremendous learning experience. And it forged bonds which still exist 50 years later.
I got a job as an announcer, intending to stay 6 months or so, to get some experience and then go back home to Melbourne. I considered it home back then.
I decided to record a short segment by talking to children all about Christmas.
What is it now, about 38 years later, I'm still here. And I, as Murray said, I started off as an announcer, just a staff announcer, doing things like BHP High School Quiz, and then I was co-opted into the news by reading the voiceovers and the regional roundup, a little 6-minute regional roundup segment that I used to read.
Way back in 1962, I auditioned for The Swallows Juniors and was fortunate enough to actually be selected to be one of the Swallows Juniors, and appeared on that for the next many years, through really till I was 16. Probably the first time, or well, many, many times, because it was a weekly event that I actually went to NBN. And where the car park is now, I can still remember driving into Mosborough Crescent and turning into the right, and they're all glass doors, and we walked through, and of course the monitors were there, the television was on, and greeted at the reception, and it was in awe of all of it, as I think a child would be, as I think anybody would be, if you were lucky enough to appear on a regular TV show or any appearance at all. You better watch out, you better not cry. The connection of the songs, the connection of learning to act, the drama, the piano, the musician side, the dancing side, all of that together made the package, I guess, of Miss Kim, that allowed me to be the hostess of Romper Room for so many years. I had about 10 minutes before every program to just meet and greet the children, and I would talk to them, and you would get to know that one little girl, Sally, might have plaits, or Peter might have a red shirt on, or Callan might have little denim shorts on, and just talking to them, and their little characters would come through, and I don't know, I think I just train myself to get to know little ways of remembering and identifying each child, because we would go through, there'd be 40 children per recording day coming through the studio, so it was a lot. Yeah.
They were the days when local production was something the Australian television industry was proud of. We're a little bit different in NBN because that innovation and the ability to have a go. Like for a young bloke, 23 or 24, to have your own sports show, like you see on the networks on Sunday morning now.
And welcome back to Sports Review 1977.
To commentate over a weekend National Basketball League game, a National Soccer League game, and a rugby league game or a rugby union game, all in the one, three OBs in a weekend, Friday night, Saturday, Sunday. You try to get a young bloke, young kids say to me now, David, how do I start? Well, I can't tell them that because you can't start like I started. It was a unique era, one that I was grateful, that I was absolutely part of, and I cherished it. But in those embryonic days of the 70s, they were the trailblazers. They set the benchmark. You look through the networks now and the number of great people that they've produced to Australian television. You look at Newcastle and look at the champions that that city's produced. It looked as though NBN and Newcastle were put there for a purpose.
So it's been great coming to work alongside your brother. Paul used to tag along with us in the early days on the odd sort of night shift or call out. You know, he was pretty eager to go. We sort of shared a bit of a fondness for photography and things like that as we were growing up, and adventure, I suppose. Paul's probably a whole lot more adventurous than me in some ways. You know, he's been through hang gliders, fast cars, motorbikes. You know, that's Paul's sort of adventure thrill or thrill buzz, I suppose.
Now, Andy's pretty much done almost every job in television as far as news and production goes.
We haven't quite found the right one yet.
Yeah. You might get it right one of these days.
Maybe.
Yeah. But yeah, no, done a lot of different jobs from lighting and sound and camera work, and then sort of retrained and became a journalist, and now working as the chief of staff, and had a lot of awards along the way. So yeah, he's had quite an amazing career in the industry. A lot of people kind of stick in their one little area of knowledge and don't branch out, but he's really branched out and done a lot of different things in the industry.
I think it is a milestone. 50 years. 50 years of wonderful television, of local television. That of course is now has grown very much outside the Hunter Valley in which it actually started.
They've done wonderfully well, and I wish them all the very best in the many years to come, and congratulations on a great 50. One of the best I've seen.
It is a time to look back and say, well, what have we done? Where are we going? And look, in another 50 years time, of course, we won't be here, but NBN will, of course.
It's more than just the job part of it. You do learn and share experiences with people all the way ever since I've worked here. There's been some really valuable life lessons, I guess, and they're not just work colleagues, they're people who really are part of your life.